ek cheez to zarur hai ki when Kajol walks in, you can't stop being wowed by that. But I'm going to bring back myself to the moment here and ask somehow, what is Helicopter Eela really?
Helicopter Eela is a funny, cool, very, very relevant film in today's day and time. And I think what's really nice about it is that it's saying what it needs to say without, you know, trying to shove it down your throat. And in the happiest and funniest way possible, right. Most importantly. It's a story about a mother and son. It's a story about Eela. It's a story about a mother and son. Their relationship and about, you know, where she is in her life at that particular point in time. And I think that's what's so cool about it, because it talks about women, it talks about women's empowerment, it talks about kids, it talks about teenager angst, it talks about, you know, who you are here and now, what you've given up, why you've given it up,
yeah.
What you've forgotten about. And at the same time, it talks about it in a very, very relatable way.
Right. Yeah. So, like, helicopter is what I'm understanding, and helicopter being Eela is the helicopter parent, right? Yes. Are you that in your life?
I think I am. I am up to a point, not to that extent. I may not be a helicopter, I may be a drone. I'm a drone. I'm not really a helicopter.
Right, Riddhi, what do you have to say? You're playing the son in the movie, right?
Right, right.
Like,
right.
How is she on the sets, and how is it for her to be playing your mother?
Oh, it was absolutely superb. A dream come true, definitely, for any actor.
Yeah.
And
considering how many times you got slapped in the film,
so yeah, and now I have.
That's quite a valid. I don't know whether it's a valid statement or
yeah,
not.
Yeah, it
actually is.
Bada
ho gaya.
Did you get the motherly vibes?
Yeah, but and also similarly a friendly vibe that is more relevant, I guess, because whenever we
you
meet,
get a motherly vibe.
No, friendly vibe. Friendly vibe. That is much better. And.
I can give you a motherly vibe right now.
That is equivalent to a slap, but
But how were you while growing up? Like, did you throw enough tantrums when you were a kid?
Yeah, I did, as much as any normal kid would, and some abnormal children would as well. But yeah, of course, I threw tantrums, and I got whacked by my mom quite often. But I think what's cool about my mom was that she was not a helicopter mom at all.
Hmm.
I mean, you know, she of course was very strict with me and whatever. But at the same time, she was one of those really, really uber cool moms that in today's day and age, all the things that we talk about, all the parenting techniques that we talk about, actually she practiced.
Could you give us an example?
You know, stuff like, you know, talking about everything. I mean, there was no taboo subject in the house.
Did you discuss your boyfriends growing up?
I did not discuss my boyfriend so much, but yes, with my mother, I have discussed my boyfriend. My current husband, who was my boyfriend at that time as well, was discussed, dissected, analyzed to great length. Yeah, by my mother, my sister, me, my mama, my mommy, we all used to live together. So yeah, my cousins, we all, I discussed, dissected and analyzed him to death.
Also, you are dealing with teens at home.
Yeah.
So is there something that you find it's so difficult that you wish you had your mother on beck and call? Or is that a call?
I have my mother on beck and call whenever I feel like it. But I think that, like I said, my mom was a very brave parent.
Hmm.
Like, I know for a fact that, I don't know whether for a fact I would be able to follow her, the advice that she gives me, you know. I don't know whether I'd really be able to follow that kind of advice. She was truly brave.
Hmm. But then also you have, over the years now, we don't know if that's because of the kids or whatever, but you have become like a very sort of a controlled sort of person. You were very outspoken earlier.
I am outspoken. I still am. I'm probably able to express myself better in a more kinder way today than I was earlier. I am more tolerant today in more ways. I am more intolerant in a lot of ways. So I've changed. I have changed, I have grown, I hope I have grown for the better. And like I said, that I still have my opinion, but I just have a better way of putting it forward, that's it.
So we were talking about Pradeep Sarkar. As a director, he's done a lot of female, women-oriented movies, right, from Parinita, Laga Chunri Mein Daag. Did you think that is why Ajay thought that, because he has such a a good hold on women and their emotions? Is that one of the reasons that...
I think that is partly the reason. But I think the most important reason is that we both felt that Dada also had the sensibility, had a wonderful sense of humor, had a wonderful sensibility to make this kind of a film. And we both worked with Dada before. So we both knew that he was an awesome director, and we knew for a fact that he would be able to do justice to the script.
Right. You also played a singer in this movie.
Yeah. I can't sing. And don't ask me to either.
Well, I'm sure you can act to sing, right? Like, okay. Actor doesn't
sing, I'll lip sing.
I'll lip sing to it. Yeah. Right.
Yeah, okay.
1, 2, 3. Ye dil hai mera ya hai, ek yaadon ki almari. इस अलमारी में रखी है मैंने अपनी ये दुनिया सारी. Wow, in a male voice, क्या बात है.
But glad that you sang this one. This has been one of my favorite songs also on loop. What do you think about it? I think the songs are really
beautiful songs.
Yeah, whether this is this one or
no. I actually love the album. I think the album is
so versatile.
Superb. Yeah, it is really superb.
And I think Mamma ki Parchai. Even that one is
Mamma ki Parchai, and Swanand has written it so well.
Yes, from the perspective of a 19-year-old or a 20-year-old kid, and from the perspective of a 90s mamma.
Yeah, exactly.
So Yaadon ki Almari and Mamma ki Parchai, Gen Y song. What amazing lyrics, yeah. And what amazing tune made by Amit Trivedi.
Right, exactly. Yes. Beautiful songs. But Kajol, talking about like when you had come to the industry, right? I remember there was this little interview you were with Karan Johar, and you had said that, you know, I had told him while he was entering the film industry that it's a big bad world outside. Yeah. And I think you were too naive for it. You're too sweet for it. Now, after that,
then he proved me wrong.
Did he? Oh, then he's not naive. Good one then. So, but then after so many years, now that you have spent so many years in Bollywood, do you still feel like an outsider, where you still call Bollywood ki nahi yaar, ye bahut badi big bad world out there is still there? Or you feel now it's...
You know, honestly, it's not the big bad world or anything like that. I just feel that wherever you are, you have to find your place in it. And he hadn't till then. I mean, it was his first foray into it. And I just thought things would go easier for him, you know, if he showed himself to be a little, you know, a little tough, a little cooler. And I think that's the way it is with in any sphere or in any part of the world or in any industry for that matter.
Right.
You need to stand up, you know, and be a little, you know, tough looking. You can't be like, you know, oh, I'm a doormat and walk all over me. So that's really all that I was trying to tell him.
But have people, I can't imagine, but has ever people tried to walk all over you? Like, have...
No.
Is the film industry like that? No, and that's either...
No.
And that's why that you have, that Kajol will not take.
Nothing like that. I think also that I have never probably given that vibe out. That, right. You know, you can say whatever you like to me or anything like that. I just have a very clear-cut way of dealing with people around me. So everybody knows their limits, right. As to... I would not step across that limit. And neither would I expect you to step across that limit with
right.
me. So it's that's really it.
That's casual for you. But then how was also working with Riddhi?
Riddhi was awesome to work with. The first day met him actually to work with, I told him, I said, you should take a Zappies and come to work. I said, take one nice Valium or, you know, take a sleeping calm tablet down. Or something. You need something to like calm you down. You're like jumping off the roof, literally. But yeah, he calmed down after the third day. Or 4-5 thappad padne ke baad sab calm down.
But thappad kya tha? Bullying hua? Yes, sir, thappad hua. Bullying hua? Said par?
No. Bilkul not at all.
And thappad
was...
Did I?
What are you saying?
What did I say?
Do you really mean that?
I'm not saying anything.
You're not saying anything. Yeah.
I'm just asking.
You're just asking.
But then how did the movie happen to you? Tell me more about your journey to become...
It was very weird. I mean, I worked in an ad with Dada.
Right.
And I never thought an ad could lead to a movie like this. So then, because I did that ad with him, so he called me up one day and he told me that he's planning a movie after like 3.5 years now. And it's a mother and son story. And she will be playing the mother and I'm supposed to play the son. So I was blown off totally after hearing such news. But I thought I have to go through an auditioning process or... anything like that.
Right.
But then I come to Bombay suddenly. He asked me to come to Bombay. And that very evening, I end up meeting her. And I got to know that I'm already there in the movie. And the next day, very next day, we start working on the movie because he has a process of recording an audiobook. So he records the movie. Like, he gets all his actors, several...
Just sit down and, you know, kind of voice artists. The script.
Wow.
And we record the entire script.
So we actually know the runtime for the film and things like that.
What all we need to improve and work on. And the next day I started working on the project. So it all happened so fast that like by the end of the shoot, I didn't even realize that, okay, the shoot is over now. Okay. So that's how it happened.
Right. But talking about younger actors, what do you have to say about, you know, there's lots that have come in the industry now. Which ones are your favorite if you had to pick some?
I think Ranbir is a fabulous actor, Ranbir Kapoor. I think he's a superb actor. I've said that before. I think Ranveer Singh has really, you know, kind of done some fabulous roles. Right. Who else? I think...
any of the actresses that you want to...
I think all of them, honestly, are at a wonderful level. And I think it's amazing what all they've done with themselves. You know, whether you're talking about Priyanka Chopra or Deepika Padukone, or you're talking about everybody, and, you know, or you're talking about Anushka for that matter. I think all of them have this innate readiness about them, you know, to be able to face whether it's the camera or whether it's the digital world or whether it's questions off camera.
Right.
I think I think they're like, you know, prepared and sitting, and I'm amazed at their preparedness.
Right, but then having done so much work that you have in your career, is there one movie that you don't want your kids today to watch?
Which one of my films? They don't watch any of my films anyways.
Kuch bhi nahi dekha abhi tak.
Kuch bhi nahi dekha. They watch bits and pieces and then they tell me that, you know, mom, you do these films and why you're crying all the time. And I said, yeah, that's true actually. I've cried in all of my films. Which film have I not cried in?
But I've laughed in love also. Yeah, you've laughed also. You've fallen in love.
But the point is that they don't agree with that. They're like, you know, why are you crying? Why do you have tears in your eyes? And we don't want to watch you crying on screen. So, you know, you should do films like Papa. Papa does such nice films like Golmaal. You should do Golmaal. Yeah. I was like, where can I fit in? Pick up a lamppost and I'm like, give me a lamppost.
So that's what the kids have to say. Yeah, interesting journey there. But then moving on, we've understood a lot about this. I thought I would do like a little bit of a style segment with you guys. The first question for you is, one fashion statement which you like from your mom's era.
From my mom's era, I honestly loved her catwing eyeliner.
Yeah.
I loved the way they did their eyeliners, all their photographs of, you know, the way they did their liner. They were liner goddesses. I don't think anybody does liner like that anymore. Just the way they did it was just fab.
Absolutely. That's definitely one fashion statement. One accessory you are obsessed with.
Watch. Any day watches. I love watches. And like big ones, not like small and like I love like big round watches.
Nice. What do you think about airport looks? Yay or nay?
I think airport looks. I think the word I take objection to. Why should it be a look? At that point of time, I assume you're going to be traveling for like 6, 7, 8 hours. Minimum. I assume the look should be about comfort. Rather than, you know, whether you have the right shoes to match the right jacket or whatever.
So a nay from Kajol for that.
Definitely.
Okay, one fashion trend men shouldn't try.
Skinny pants?
Yes, I agree. Dhoti pants are fine, but like those like narrow...
No, the single pants.
Yes, I agree.
And the ones with the bigger bum and then the ankles just go amazing to watch them.
It's like cartoon figures, you know. It's
I
like
love
caricature.
Baggy pants whenever it comes to men. They should wear baggy pants more. It looks cooler.
All right. Maybe. Baggy pants for Riddhi.
Yes.
Time to play a game with you guys. And this one is called hashtag.
Okay.
Ma to ma hai. Huh. Why don't you look happy about this? By the way, there's a Zoom weekend or hamper that comes with it. So,
there's a hamper.
There you go.
Okay, chalo. You have to give us the right, you know, incentive.
Incentive, yeah.
I got it. Like, okay. I love how the posture is changed.
Yes.
Also, I would like to now show you like a look of the
and
hamper.
And if that hamper turns out to be, you know, one coffee mug or something like that.
I knew you will come to that. That is why I will show you.
Something expensive and nice.
Here comes your expensive hamper. Bring it in. All right, here's the hamper.
Okay, headphones.
Headphones, yeah. So I don't even have to explain to you guys. It's very heavy. Let me tell you, there's like some...
charger.
Yeah, you guys are completely... There's some...
You can take the chocolates in the bag.
There are chocolates in the bag, but there are definitely speakers and a Bluetooth speaker.
See, she's a music person.
Headphones.
She's gonna take all the music from there.
One in hand is better than two in the bush.
I agree.
Okay,
we are sharing it. Go ahead.
Why am I even playing the game there?
That's just to entertain you and keep you satisfied. Don't worry.
has happened is ki we went around, hum logon ne kuch aisi bahut sari maaon se baat ki jinke bade hi same teenage kind of sons and daughters hain. We asked them ki aap is situation mein kya karte.
Okay.
So we got some popular answers, right? Oh, yes. Now you two have to figure out which is the most popular answer out of all these.
Interesting.
Yeah?
Okay. Let's bring it on.
All right. First question. Your daughter is going for a party. What would you say? First option, ladke bhi honge party mein. Two, दारू वगैरह तो नहीं होगा ना, 12 बजे से पहले आ जाना. थर्ड, इतने छोटे कपड़े पहनने की क्या जरूरत है. फोर्थ, आह मेरी बेटी कितनी प्यारी लग रही है, कौन सा लड़का तुझे लेने आ रहा है बेटा.
दिस इज डिफिकल्ट. आई हैव अ टाई बिटवीन द फर्स्ट एंड द फोर्थ.
द मोस्ट पॉपुलर, व्हिच वन डू यू थिंक द मोस्ट मॉम सेड.
आई थिंक नंबर 4.
ओके,
एग्जैक्टली.
सो यू बोथ आर रॉन्ग. इट्स द सेकंड वन.
रियली?
या
व्हाट?
Yeah. Yeah. Your child is upset with you and darwaza band karke baith ke andar, what would you do? Darwaza band karne ki kya zarurat hai? Two, choti si baat mein muh utar jata hai, pada rahe andar, bhook lagegi to aayega apne aap. Third, ek tamacha marungi, dimag thakane aa jayega, darwaza khol. Fourth one, Veera, I know you're upset. Gate khol de, tere liye pakode banaye.
It's definitely not the last one.
Definitely the last one.
It is not the last one.
Second option ke sath.
Second option, I will go with third option because it could be the third option.
Oh, achha, second and third. Second, third.
And third.
And third option is the right answer.
That's the first one. We have won it. We have won it. Okay.
All right, Kajol 1, Riddhi 0.
हम पॉइंट्स शेयर करेंगे.
शेयर करेगा. See, this is a mother son bond, you can't help it.
आपने अपने बेटे को मार्केट में देखा और पीछे एक लड़की बैठी थी. What would you say? वो शर्मा जी की लड़की तेरे बाइक के पीछे क्यों बैठी थी? हाथ रख के.
हाथ?
हाथ रख के.
हाँ.
Two, अपनी पसंद की लड़की लाएगा घर में, माँ की जरूरत ही नहीं है अब जनाब को. थर्ड ऑप्शन, ज्यादा पढ़ निकल आए हैं, कल से बाइक पे जाना बंद. फोर्थ ऑप्शन, बेटा कौन थी वो लड़की, घर पे लाओ, मिलवाओ.
Third and fourth.
Huh? Third and fourth, because fourth is very diplomatic. Huh?
I thought one answer, fourth. Guys. The game works on
third and fourth.
Fourth, third.
And third and fourth.
This is bad.
The correct answer is zyada par nikal aaye hain, kal se bike pe jana band.
Ha, to mera hai na.
Yeah. Oh. 2-0.
One. Sharing.
Fine. Fourth one. Your daughter wants to stay at a friend's place overnight. What do you say? फर्स्ट, घर खाली है या उसके पेरेंट्स बाहर हैं? टू, पढ़ाई का प्लान है या पार्टी का बेटा? थ्री, तुम्हें जाने की क्या जरूरत है, उसको यहाँ बुला लो. फोर्थ, एंजॉय कर ना बेटा, मगर फोन हमेशा उठा लेना.
थ्री टू.
यू आर रियली अ मदर, हां, लाइक रियली लाइक अ मदर. मदर. थर्ड इज द राइट आंसर. तुम्हें जाने की क्या जरूरत है.
ओके. But I don't know why we are shaking hands, because she's winning.
Yeah, and I don't know why you even agreed to share your hand. But now do you see why you shouldn't have agreed to
it? I'm the producer.
Oh. Oh, now Amma chali ke producer aa gayi. Producer is nice. All right. Last question. Aapka bachcha bahar se ladke pit kar aaya hai.
What? Ladke pit kar aaya.
Haan. What would your reaction be? Kahin chot to nahi lagi beta? Dikha idhar face. Second, tune palat ke mara nahi. Third, कौन कौन था, हीरो बनने की क्या जरूरत थी. फोर्थ, झगड़ा करना गलत बात है बेटा, मैं उसकी मम्मी से बात करती हूँ.
सेकंड एंड थर्ड.
सेकंड,
यू टेक सेकंड एंड आई टेक थर्ड.
एक काम करती हूँ, हैंपर मैं ही ले जाती हूँ. एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग. कौन सी माँ से बोलती है?
अरे
अरे,
कौन सी माँ से बोलती है, मतलब
हाँ, कहीं चोट नहीं लगी बेटा, फेस दिखा. दैट्स द रियल मदर्स टॉकिंग.
गलत माँ से बात
की.
ईला से बात नहीं की. Guys, well done. Big round of applause for you.
Clap for me.
Bajalo, apne liye bajalo.
I win.
So, we do have a winner now. And yes. Are you regretting now sharing your hamper? There goes this Yoni.
Thank you. Jesse, thank you so much.
Hai, by the way.
It's matching also, exactly.
Yeah, it was actually this time to be there.
It's fab. Don't worry, I'll give you part of it that I don't want of anything that I don't want out of it, I'll give you.
Haan, bilkul.
And in case I don't have anything that I don't want.
Aur jisne jitaya, usko kuch nahi?
Ribbon.
Haan, we can unwrap.
All right, guys, with that, I would like to say thank you to both of them. Because mujhe toh kuch milne wala nahi hai. Thank you and all the best for this movie. The trailer and everything else, the music looks fantastic.
Thank you.
And this is what I get. So on that note, thank you so much. This is Zoom Weekend Show with me, Gunjan. I will see you next week. Iske baad aane wali hai Sakshma. So do watch the movie review.
हेलो आप सबका स्वागत है एक बार फिर जूम वीकेंड शो पर. ब्रेक के पहले हेलीकॉप्टर ईला के कलाकार काजोल और रिद्धि सेन ने हमें अपनी फिल्म के बारे में कई दिलचस्प बातें बताईं. ये फिल्म एक माँ और बेटे के रिश्ते के बारे में है, किस तरह ईला की दुनिया सिर्फ उसके बेटे विवान के इर्द गिर्द घूमती है. एक माँ का कर्तव्य निभाते निभाते कहीं ईला भूल चुकी है कि उसके अपने सपने क्या हैं, उसके अपने अरमान क्या हैं. इसके वजह से विवान को कहीं ना कहीं एक घुटन सी महसूस होने लगी है और उसके आगे क्या होता है ये जानने के लिए आपको ये फिल्म खुद देखनी पड़ेगी. इस फिल्म में काजोल ने थोड़ा निराश किया है क्योंकि उनकी एक्टिंग से ज़्यादा ओवर एक्टिंग देखने को मिली है. परफॉर्मेंस नेचुरल नहीं है और लुक में भी काफ़ी खामियां हैं. मेकअप इतना ज़्यादा है जैसे हिंदी टेलीविजन के डेली सोप से कोई कॉम्पिटिशन चल रहा हो. मतलब बच्चा जस्ट पैदा किया है लेकिन लिपस्टिक, आई शेडो, ब्लश सब एकदम बराबर है. रिद्धि सेन सिर्फ 19 साल की उम्र में भारत सरकार से बेस्ट एक्टर का राष्ट्रीय फिल्म पुरस्कार जीत चुके हैं, तो जाहिर सी बात है कि उनका काम भी बहुत प्रभावशाली है. नेहा धोपिया ने भी बहुत खूब अपना किरदार निभाया. पिक्चर में गाने ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा हैं और स्क्रीन प्ले में भी बहुत सारी गलतियाँ हैं. जैसे जैसे आगे बढ़ती है स्टोरी बेमतलब होती जाती है. कहानी में कुछ नया नहीं है और आप ऐसी कहानियाँ कई बार बड़े पर्दे पर देख चुके हैं. मैं सजेस्ट करूंगी आप अपना दिमाग घर पर छोड़ के ये पिक्चर देखने जाइए, मज़ा आएगा. हाँ, उतनी एंटरटेनिंग तो है ही. इस फिल्म से ज़्यादा उम्मीदें ना ही रखे तो बेहतर है. मैं इसे 3 स्टार्स दे रही हूँ. मेरी माने तो आनंद एल राय की तुम्बाड़ इससे बहुत बेटर पिक्चर है. अगर एक फिल्म को ही चुनना हो तो तुम्बाड़ देखिए. चलिए अब आपसे विदा लेते हैं. अगले हफ्ते फिर मिलेंगे शाम 7 बजे. तब तक डू टेक वेरी गुड केयर ऑफ योरसेल्फ एंड कीप वॉचिंग जूम.